Hey guys, thanks for tuning in to another episode of A Word with Words, the podcast. We want to take the time out to thank our friends at Strong University. Make sure you go to stronguniversity.online and run it up. Spend that check, spend a bag. Thanks.
5, 4, 3, 2.
Hey guys, welcome to another episode of A Word with Words, the podcast. It's your girl, Bree Stories.
It's your girl, A. Tati.
It's Aja No Asia.
And we're here with G. Dot Markee. Hey, so let's jump into it because mama's tired. So we're going to do a check-in. If you're not familiar, we're going to do a check-in. You may not be familiar with the format, but we'll go first and then you'll fit right into it. I don't want to go first.
Okay, well, hi, everybody. Welcome to Away With Words, the podcast, and I'm checking in, and mentally, you know, I'm here, I got some things in motion that I'm proud of. And some things that are coming to life. I don't want to speak on them yet because that's how, you know, people start wishing ill will. And I don't need that. But, you know, things are moving forward. It's growth. It's about growth. And so that's how I feel mentally. I'm just getting shit straightened out.
I feel like I never hear you say the word shit.
Shit. Yeah. Like so that. Let me tell y'all what else kind of shit I got going on. Physically, I feel rested, I guess. I was feeling like, y'all know I was sick last week, so I was feeling kind of sickly and shitty, but now shit's going good. So, that's how I feel physically. Emotionally, I was really emotional last week, y'all. It was just a lot going on. I was crying at Catfish. I was very emotional last week, but I'm better now, and my intentions, is here with G. Dot Markee and enjoying our interview.
Woo! Hey, Tati, how do you feel?
I feel good. Ooh, I feel so good. If anybody was a Richmond Park Raider cheerleader,
that's
then you know
true.
Exactly what I meant. What?
Because they didn't. When I was a Raider, we didn't do that one.
Anyways, I'm feeling good, feeling great. Emotionally, I feel good. Physically, I'm a little sore. Been working out a lot.
Right, I heard you. I said, like, yeah, go girl, you've been in the gym. She's nasty, because I wasn't thinking that way.
Who?
Her.
Oh.
That was some birds.
No. Anyways, what did I say?
You
physically,
said,
emotionally,
yeah.
Mentally, I'm feeling good as well. I think I feel pretty, I'm just pretty chill today. And my attention, however, is on the end of this month because I haven't been eating any desserts and any sweets
desserts.
This whole month. So I've been thirsty for February 1st to roll around because I'm going to get a donut. And I'm really excited.
I couldn't
about
do it for the month of January because January is just so long. I would do it like in February.
Everybody says that, but I feel like this month fucking.
No,
flow.
Girl.
No, this month been long.
I don't know.
Day 99.
It's already February this week. Like, that's crazy.
Yeah, I find I'm used to months always being 30 days or 31 days. February is the only month that's shorter than that. So, it's not really. What? What'd you say? I didn't even hear you.
Bree Stories.
Hi. Bree Stories checking in. Physically, I feel. Physically, I feel full. Emotionally, I feel joy and sadness via fatigue. Very tired. And my attention is currently on, I think, my birthday. I think I'm just now starting to get into the swing of my birthday is coming up. And spiritually I feel very, very excited. I'm on a new journey. I'm starting some things on my birthday. I'm getting into some new brujeria, and I'm excited about that. And I will make sure I update y'all on that, because lots of things are coming. So, Dot Markee, how do you feel?
So it's physically, mentally, emotionally.
Nope.
Physically, emotionally.
Yeah.
Putting my attention's on.
Yeah.
Physically, emotionally.
I'm gonna remember. It'd be spiritual.
And damn. Y'all didn't say spiritual.
No, sure. They do what they like, you know.
I forgot.
And it's okay.
Physically,
I love you guys.
I'm feeling. physically, I'm feeling like a little drained. You know, I ain't been getting my rest like I need to get it.
Gotta go to sleep.
I mean, you're on the world
tour. Yeah, I wish. I got work though. But emotionally, I'm feeling drained. You know. We've been taking a lot of L's this month, so, you know, just ready to get out of this month. So
yeah.
That's why when you said it's feeling like it flew by, I'm like, nah, this month kind of bothered me. Yeah. And then my attention focused on my project.
Yes.
You know, I'm locked in on this show we putting together on March 29th.
Ooh.
At the Promontory.
And
spiritually, always in a good place. Always in a good place spiritually.
Was that his show?
Yes, it was!
Well,
you did a show.
I
got on stage. I tried to get on stage.
you performed, and we were just out in the crowd.
That's when I was like, yeah, fuck mama.
Bray was in the crowd, like, I'm gonna get on that stage. And I was like, no, G, I don't think you should. She tried to get on stage, like,
security wasn't going either.
I said, did you make it?
No, he was not folding for it.
Why did you want to get on the stage?
I don't know. I was drunk and
if you want to get on the show
time.
This time, you get on
I can
stage.
Get on stage?
Just let me know.
To sing, though.
No.
I was like, oh, I can't sing.
I'm going to get up there and do a handstand.
Okay.
I mean, if that's what you want.
I was thinking that.
She'll do it. Anyway, so let's talk to Dot Markee for a little bit. Dot Markee, so for anybody who does not... Oh, we can take a shot to be in our text
off.
Shit.
No.
To Dot Markee.
Yes, to Dot Markee.
Yeah, of course.
Thanks for being
great.
Here.
Yeah.
Gang.
I feel like I've been taking shots nonstop for like 5 days.
Not me.
That's what you like.
That's only my second time drinking.
What was
shit.
Your name? What did you say, call yourself?
Young Never Learn.
There you go. Young who?
Young Never Learn.
Love it.
That's me. I wake
you
up with a hangover
names.
And then I get real drunk 2 hours later. So, anyway, now let's talk to Dot Markee.
Yes.
Dot Markee.
What up?
My name is Billy, and I am from Southern Illinois somewhere. I have no idea about anything. Tell me who you are.
I know a Billy in Southern Illinois.
Really?
Yeah.
I'm not that Billy. I'm the one that doesn't know you.
Tell you what now?
Just all the things that you, like, give us your elevator pitch. I feel like I ask that a lot.
So
I think that's my
signs,
thing.
Signs, likes, dislikes.
Zodiac
position.
Oh, yes, let's do that. Tell us your name, your zodiac sign, your favorite color, your favorite position, and your favorite drink. Five
things.
You're
going to
be my quarterback.
Come on, why you spoiling?
Now you can't do
Zodiac
that.
Zodiac sign. Favorite drink.
Favorite drink.
Favorite color. Favorite position.
G Dot Markee. Please say the G Dot.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. Or, oh my God, if that's a Marcus, that's the O. But, you know, it's still that.
Job.
Favorite color, green, of course.
You skip it.
No, that's too much. See, green, of course.
Green because monies or because of vegetation? The most important thing, trees.
Because of the earth?
Green represents life to me.
Word.
Right, earth.
Oh, wow.
You need money in life.
Yeah.
You need trees, whatever you need.
Real shit.
Zodiac sign, I'm a Cancer, so, you know, I'm a hard worker, very diligent.
Makes sense.
What was the rest?
Favorite position.
And what?
Favorite drink.
Favorite drink and favorite position.
Favorite drink, water. And favorite position,
sexual position. Not position at companies, right?
I just like to be the boss.
Favorite position in sex? I ain't gonna lie. I like all the positions. Freak.
He's like, I like the one where my dick is in it.
I'm down to try new things.
Oh, that's good. I didn't take you as the type. That's nice to hear.
She caught you in your way.
You have a very militant spirit about you. So you put me off as somebody that'll be like, nah, bitch, we doing it like this and this only. But that's not a bad thing.
I mean, sometimes. You know, sometimes it's like, nah.
I'm a reader.
And other times it's like, you know.
Do what you want with me.
Not what you want with me.
Have your way with me.
Yeah, there you go.
That's the same thing.
Okay,
no,
so.
It's a little different.
We're getting off track. So, I'm still Billy. I'm from Southern Illinois. I shouldn't have been hearing about sexual positions because I'm also 12. So, tell me.
She has identity issues.
What? Tell me. I'm trying to paint the picture. Tell me about Dot Markee, the artist.
I've been doing music for a long time. I rap and I engineer.
Yes.
As far as musically, I wasn't really feeling music after I dropped out of college. I didn't really know what I was on, but losing my sister really put me in a position where it's like, nah, I'm going all the way out with this, you know.
Yeah.
Period. Because she was telling me that this is something I should be doing, you know.
Right.
Whether it be being an artist or just being in the industry somewhere, because she saw how happy it made me. So
yeah.
That's pretty much it about me musically.
I love that.
I can rap any style. I can rap on any beat.
I can attest to
that. I just want to say, I agree.
Definitely. That's awesome. So tell us about the latest project, which right now, y'all who are watching, y'all can go cop this right now.
In the Name of Gabby.
Yes.
It's a deluxe copy right here.
Come on, deluxe.
Designed by my boys, Austin Williams and Kendall Sutton.
Awesome.
They handled everything as well as cards. They go hand in hand.
That's so innovative.
We got some black people.
All right, that's fantastic.
I'm gonna play spades with them cards this weekend.
I love that because I think that spades is the national nigga pastime. So why not
have cards?
Yeah, I actually despise spades, but because it's the national nigga pastime. But it's great. I love those.
It's just the cards represent something that's real close to me because my father is a real big card player, and growing up, that's how he taught me my numbers 1 through 9.
That's awesome.
I already learned my numbers, so that's why that's near and dear to me. Mm-hmm. And obviously the music, I already said, you know.
Yeah.
It's obviously a dedication track on there, but it's not all like sad and somber music.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
It's really music that I created that I know she would have liked to hear from me. Mm-hmm. You know, me telling the truth about myself.
Yeah.
So that's basically it with this.
Yeah, and even though, of course, you went out of your way to make sure that every song wasn't, you know, sad and solemn, but what was that creative process like? What was it like to know what was on your heart for this project and to make, like, a turn-up song? What was that process like?
The process started, I would say, right when we lost her. Mm-hmm. We went in the studio during that week before the funeral, actually. And I made a song that was obviously very sad, you know? So after we created that, we went back, you know, and I was actually compiling a bunch of music that I already had, because it was supposed to come out last year around this time.
Mm-hmm.
And I hit a wall, artistically, like I wasn't in it. And so I just scrapped the whole project, only kept that one song. And I was just waiting for inspiration.
Yeah.
Around the middle of the year last year, I actually got into a creative space and I knocked out the other 9 songs in like a matter of a month.
Oh, that's fantastic.
I was just like in the zone. So really, it was just, you know, I made the one song basically about, you know, how I was feeling in the moment, and mm-hmm. then the rest of it is like a reflection of how I feel now about that situation. Really just like, you know, I can't go back. Yeah. I can't change nothing. Yeah. That's how I'm living my life from here on out. And that's mm-hmm. what the music is really kind of brash, mm-hmm. kind of what's the word I'm looking for? Not necessarily arrogant, but more so unapologetic mm-hmm. about who I'm gonna be in life. You know?
I love that.
I feel like that's who you've always been. Like, you're just you. You know what I'm saying? Like, you yeah. don't put on a facade, or like, you've always been like, you know how like every group of high school you have like the hipster, like the cool kid. This has always been like you. You know what I'm saying? Like, he's always been in his own lane.
Yeah. I appreciate yeah. that, because I never wanted to fit in. I always wanted to just be me mm-hmm. and stand out.
That's definitely you.
I appreciate
that. Yeah, you definitely do. And you command a presence. And I remember a couple of times seeing you rap. It's just like, it's an experience. I think that's why I'm so curious about your studio experience, because seeing you rap live is definitely an experience.
Yeah, well, I remember when we went to the promontory where Bree couldn't contain her. No, and of course, I'm like always, like I said before, like I always be like, I'm going to support my people no matter what. But I saw Marcus perform, and I hadn't seen you perform since like high school. Right. And I was like, he's like so good. Yeah. Like, it's crazy.
Well, I always wanted to make it a point, especially since I've been taking it seriously professionally, mm-hmm. that I don't want people to support me. I don't want people just pulling up and spending their hard-earned money just because I'm their friend.
Right,
you know, maybe
right.
the first time, but when they come and spend that money, I want to give them the experience of, wow, this is something that I believe in.
Yeah.
You know, mm-hmm.
And you definitely do that.
Mm-hmm. Well, I appreciate
yeah,
it.
For yeah, sure. For sure. You're very artistic, and that's another thing that I think that is important. I think that a lot of people are so trapped in the conversation of how hip-hop is lost and how like our generation don't know, blah 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 blah. But there's so many people, and you're one of them, that, you know, and it's amazing to know you on a personal level as well. But you're very almost meticulous, it seems like. You're, like, it's a serious thing. It's not just like, even how you said, like, you hit a wall and you allowed yourself the creative space to get back to it instead of being like, nah, we gotta crank this shit out, which is what a lot of people do, yeah. you know?
Well, because, like, music, especially at that point, it just didn't make sense. It was like, I had grown so much artistically by the mm-hmm. time that music was gonna come out. It was just like, nah, this can't be for this project.
Right.
This music can come out, but yeah. it can't represent my sister, if that makes mm-hmm. any sense.
Yes.
So, mm-hmm. you know, and even this music, since I finished this, I've grown so much more since then, but my homie A. Will told me best. He was like, man, better to be finished than to be done. I mean, better to be finished than to be perfect.
Mm-hmm.
That's what he said. And I'm like, yeah, you got it right.
Yeah.
Like, at some point, you just got to put it out there, especially as an artist, you know?
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Definitely. And then you keep growing off of that, because then once, because
right.
now this is out, because it's Cyber Wednesday.
Today's Wednesday? Okay, yeah, so it came out yesterday.
Right. So, but then from this moment, you keep growing off of that. What it's all about. I love that. I think you're great. I think you're awesome.
I appreciate it.
Since we're talking music,
mm-hmm.
arguably the most important event in music, Dem Grammys.
Mm-hmm.
Let's just get into some of the hot. You watch? You indulge?
Yeah, I watch.
I thought okay. the BET Awards is the most Ooh! Important.
I mean, I ain't gonna
Come
lie.
On,
it's way more entertaining.
Yeah.
No, the BET Awards.
Actually, and the MTV Award.
I feel like VMAs. MTV
yeah.
Awards.
VMAs be tweaking a little bit sometimes, though.
Why?
Like, the VMAs is a space where, I don't know, I just, a lot of the people that run white culture,
mm-hmm.
and I hate to sound like one of those guys, but
like
it's like, I don't even know what that means. I'll be seeing that, and I don't even care to research it, because I might
that's
be
okay.
You said
I
like a what?
A hotel.
No,
I don't know what that is.
But it's like for instance, the year, you watched the Grammys yesterday.
Yes.
You seen Miley Cyrus.
Yes.
3 years ago, did you see her on the VMAs?
Yes.
That's my point. It's
yeah.
like, they allow a space for people to do that kind of stuff, and
yeah.
it's like, I don't really rock, like, you know, the
no,
Post Malones of the world and stuff like that. It's like,
But you also could see, like, the black artists on the VMAs.
Yeah, I'm not mad at it.
But it's a different space for them, I think, is what you're saying, right?
Well, what I'm saying is the VMA space is a space that allows people to openly appropriate with no checks and balances. Mm-hmm. You know, like, that's just my opinion. I could be wrong.
I could see that. No, I could see how you can come to that. Mm-hmm. Definitely.
Like, people ain't pulling up to the hip hop awards on that.
No, that's
you
true.
You feel me? Like,
right.
That's all I'm saying.
So I'm not down because I like the VMA.
You say that. I watched the VMAs, especially, was that 2 years ago? Kanye? He had his whole premiered his video with Tiana Taylor.
Oh, that was
short. It was super fire.
Oh my God.
And his speech was like, you know, I fuck with the VMAs.
I'm just saying. Yeah, definitely. All right. That was good.
You work there?
You feel me?
Yeah.
She was like,
I'm the actual creator of the VMAs, and that's real wild that you're saying this to me.
Well, I really didn't want to tell you all this, but.
Well, run us this money. What you talking about? Anyway, so the Grammys. So the Grammys yesterday, one of the things that stood out to me, I mean, and I just watched, rewatched an interview that Jay-Z did about a month ago. And one of the things that he said is something that I firmly believe in, which is the climate of our current political situation, as shitty as it is really important because it's opening up this dialogue that is now forced. Everybody is like, nah, we have to talk about these things. Like, we have to talk about racism. We have to talk about sexual harassment. We have to, like, all of these things cannot continuously be swept under the rug, and now we're in a space where we literally cannot ignore it. Like, y'all's actual president is the epitome of all of
don't
these.
Say y'all.
Not y'all.
Not even, no, it's ours.
Sure. See, this is what I'm talking about. But anyway,
sure.
That's what I'm saying. You from here?
Sure.
You benefit from here. You can't.
Sure.
It was
like
our president
I was saying,
when it was Barack, so it's our president.
Sure. Y'all's president is the epitome of all of these things.
Say like 45.
Yes, you're right. 45 is the epitome of all of literally all of this, like back to back. It's like just turning the pages of a book, like the fucking abuse of power, the racism, the sexual harassment, all the things. So we're in the space where we literally can't not talk about these things, and I think that's important. And I think that overall, while there were some technical difficulties and some other stuff that I probably saw and was just like, I could have done without that, I think overall the Grammys at large did a really good job at creating a space for that dialogue.
Yeah.
And I think a lot of people did their part in that, and I enjoyed it. I enjoyed that aspect of it.
I think the music industry is very progressive, and I think mm-hmm. that Hollywood is trying to be now. You
yeah.
know? I mean, obviously, we see what's coming out about Hollywood, so we know what it's been like. But I think the world is becoming more progressive. But, I mean, in my opinion, you know, to keep it a buck, like, in America, there'll never be a solved problem.
Mm-hmm.
You feel me? Like, it was started, built upon all of these ills, and those are always going to be here because you have people in middle America that don't really care what people is talking about. You know, like,
yeah.
New York, a major city, they got some of everybody got. Same thing with Chicago and LA and all the major cities to be progressive with as far as like the American people.
Yeah.
How you think Donald Trump became president?
Right.
You feel me? It's all of these people in all of these red states, and then the battleground states is the ones that, you know, could sway either way. So like Ohio, you know,
mm-hmm.
Virginia, you know,
yeah.
these states are the ones where, I don't know.
Where Billy from?
Right.
She said Billy from Southern Illinois. Here,
yeah.
That's a blue state.
But down there is red.
Yeah, but it's a blue state every time.
But no.
He said no, it's always blue.
Like,
let's
say you shady.
Who's shady? Oh, he's
shady.
I'm being really messy.
Anyway, what were your favorite moments? Let's go around. Favorite moments of the Grammys. And then least favorites.
So you sick of it?
I don't like award shows. Like,
oh no,
not
no. I mean, I like the singing aspect of it, but I just hate the people receive the awards. I feel like I just want to see everybody singing.
You
want
to
be a
musical?
Dance
monkey.
Oh yeah,
I just want to see constant music.
Even rappers, people who don't sing, like everybody wants to come sing.
I had a lot of favorite parts.
But so, I did like Kendrick Lamar's opening.
Yeah.
And I like,
that's the one part I missed. very beginning.
That's the part you need to see most, brother.
I mean, I'll check that too. What I missed.
Well, our brother Kendrick got up there and basically
pastor
made it up.
Fist up.
Basically.
Yeah.
As usual.
Yeah.
I could have guessed.
Exactly. And then I also like when Blue Ivy told her parents to calm down.
Yes! Now that was on her part. She said.
Like, no, it's a meme going around and said, we didn't even come here. Y'all put all business out. We went no awards. Y'all need to calm down. So I love that part about
her. Blue Ivy is hilarious. Let's not.
And Beyonce was only trying to figure out what she wanted.
Yeah, she was like, what? And JP just looked down at her and like, are you fucking kidding me?
Like, he was embarrassed.
You shushing us?
He was like, see, this is why you get whooped.
No.
So he's like, because you don't know how to act.
You said what?
The memes for them all sitting together.
What about dinner all day? I haven't seen one meme.
Really? Oh my god.
Beyonce. I've been on the internet. They don't follow
Beyonce in the church hat. Beyonce, like the whole thing. She was clutching her purse because she knows it's still.
No, I said something about Alicia Keys when she was like, I know I see you on to this whole no makeup thing. That's cool. But, like, I'm not with the whole no album thing. You need to get your life together.
Like, do something.
Yeah, like, she's like, you need to get your life together. God.
I'm trying to think of something else that I had in mind before y'all started talking about Blue. Blue is always going to distract me.
Talking about the best, your favorite parts of the Grammy.
I really, really, really enjoyed SZA's performance.
I'm excited
to
see her.
She didn't seem a little, what's the word?
No, she said
she didn't seem a little like sad. I couldn't think of a better word to say. She didn't seem a little sad.
Because
all her nominations had went on by then, and she had one. I thought she was gonna win at least one. I just knew she was gonna win.
Yeah, that was really insane to me. Okay, first of all,
anybody could have won.
She's been around for years.
She's been around. Like, it's not like. I mean, I don't know if she didn't drop an album.
I talked about this earlier. That's what I think it is. I think it's the fact that she hadn't had an album that whole time.
Right.
So I think that.
Because I mean,
that,
the album think it's 2 years ago.
The other five nominees.
Cardi B will probably be somebody that next year will be up for Best New Artist. But we'll be like, she been out. But her album isn't out yet. Right.
I enjoyed Cardi B and Bruno Mars' performance as well.
Uzi album ain't even out though, so that's why it's like.
Yeah, he was nominated. I thought he should have. Him and SZA should have won. He does have an album out.
About the
key. Is this Lil Uzi
Vert?
They got like cartoons.
Oh, you know what? That's crazy.
Stuff.
I listened to it. I did know that.
No, I think Lil Uzi and Lil Uzi Vert is the same person.
It's just one person.
I'm sorry.
Oh, I was
like,
it's two?
We're talking over each other. Two, but it's two. There's an Uzi and an Uzi Vert. No, I'm kidding. There's
just
one person. Anyway, no, I enjoyed, I think, but you know what though? That might be something that I would have to pay attention to because I, more than anything, I just enjoyed the aesthetics. And I enjoyed the fact that she chose to sing that particular song. Because she sang Broken Clocks, which is a great song. But I think that I was expecting The Weeknd because the video just dropped not too long ago. And so when she came out and that started playing, I was just like, oh shit. So I think I was excited from just like get go.
But I think.
And then the Matrix shit in the back, like the aesthetics of it were great. Like,
is The Weeknd her biggest record? Cause I know like black people love it. I was gonna say that Love Galore is like the one that I was expecting her to sing.
But I feel like she wasn't at the Grammys last year. She just did that like at the BET Awards maybe. So I feel like that would have been one that she wouldn't have done at another award show. But I wasn't expecting Broken Clocks by far. If she would have done Gardens, I would have lost my mind. But anyway. I enjoyed it. I enjoyed Bruno Mars. So here's something that I love about Bruno Mars. Bruno Mars, because I always hear.
I knew he was going
to clean up. Talking about me too, Pop Pop.
Gee, that number one, that song.
Clean up. I like that.
Well, that song was snapping for like 10 straight months.
A long time.
And the video was so cold. I'm like, gee.
I really appreciate Bruno Mars on the side of like, he does. homage so well, because I think a lot of people, are you okay?
I just said homage. He does homage so well.
Like, he dresses up.
Stop, because you know I can take this and run with it, so don't let me. No, homage, he pays homage very, very well, and he's just educated and, like, not afraid or shy in any way. I think that people fuck up, especially, like, younger artists, when they pull from certain avenues to add to their art and add to their craft, but then they, like, don't know how to articulate that they did that, so then to the consumer, it looks like you just fucking stealing shit, or you're just appropriating other people's culture, or you're doing this, or you're doing that, and I think that Bruno Mars does a fantastic job of being like, look, this is where I got this from.
Yeah.
Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, I wouldn't be on this stage without some of my favorite writers, including Babyface. Like, come on, let's talk about it, you know?
Mm-hmm.
So I really appreciate him for that aspect, and I think that that's something that a lot of people needed to see, because I think, who was I listening to? Kid Fury. Like, is always talking about how he doesn't mind, like, he doesn't hate Bruno Mars, but he's just like, all of this, oh, jump off, back off me. Like, all this, like, that's how he describes it. Like, he's like, all this, like, James Brown shit is like, stop. Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, but he always talks about
all his music ain't normally like that, though.
I know,
it's
but like,
all
like,
this, like, a time
I just imagine him doing the movie.
Yes, I picture his arms, like, he just be rocking. But, like, I think that people like that needed to see him in this light and needed to hear him talk about, I know exactly where these things are coming from. Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, I'm not out here trying to steal. I'm truly an inspired individual, which we all are as artists. Yeah. It is all about knowing how to articulate that and just being knowledgeable yourself. Because a lot of times, I'll have a melody right now and not even realize until 3-4 years later that it's a whole song already. Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, I didn't just make it up. And that's just how it is, because we're in an era where rarely are things brand spanking new. Like, you know what I'm saying? It's coming from somewhere. So it's all about being able to articulate that, and I appreciate him for that.
I liked Rihanna.
Yes.
And DJ Khaled and Bryson Tiller.
Yes.
That was definitely my favorite moment. I think that was Rihanna's favorite performance that she's ever done in her whole life.
She had
because
a blast.
She was so happy. Like, every time the camera showed her face, she was extremely happy. She had her tongue out. She was making all her dancer faces. Like, she was so happy. And she was thick. Like,
yes. I'm so here for Curvy Rihanna. Yeah. And I saw somebody put something up today, because I watched that that performance twice. And one of the things that I was impressed by, because people have always tried to, like, come for Rihanna on the vocal range, like, in some way or another. But one thing that I noticed about that particular song, it's kind of, like, naturally a sloppy song. Like, it's easy for you to, like, be off key. And she was very good at having control of her vocals. Like, and dancing. Like, which is something that I don't think that I really experienced with
her
Rihanna.
About it,
I know.
They always do.
And that's why I was like, what? I thought that, because it's not, like, this smooth, like, hit every note as song. It's kind of like all over the place.
Yeah.
Like, you know, you could easily
that
end up
fuck with Rihanna. That have always said those negative things about her are always gonna, like, be
saying,
like, no,
trash.
That bitch still can't sing. Right. Like, they're always gonna
she
do
seems
that.
Great
like
to
it
me.
Doesn't matter.
And she has great vocal
control.
She's
just Rihanna. Yeah. She's not.
She
doesn't
really
but
wants
Rihanna.
To talk about Rihanna.
I mean, you know.
He said, "You got Markee here."
That first outfit, boy.
The pink dress.
The leather. Was it? It wasn't leather. It looked like a trash bag. I was blue.
Oh,
that
yeah,
brown
leather.
She had on, she
yes,
went on stage,
yes,
on stage
yes,
with
yes,
Kendrick.
Yes.
She had it on.
Yes.
Like, damn,
okay.
She but then I'm like, she changed like 32 more times. I'm like,
oh, 32.
How many times did she change?
She had on like 7 outfits yesterday.
Did she?
At least. Cause
I
she
feel
performed.
Like I
she performed
twice.
With.
Yeah.
What's
her
name? Kesha.
She
did you see her after?
Cause Kesha was finna blow me. Cause at the beginning I'm like,
well, Rihanna wasn't on stage with Kesha.
Yeah, she was.
No, she was wearing white.
She was wearing white.
No,
it's a whole list of girls, and she's not on there.
You were talking, she had the bang. You
who
thinking of the lady
was
who had the bang?
It was Alicia Cara, Cindy Lauper,
like
Audra Day. It was,
I wonder if that's who you think that was.
No.
I don't know. But
it couldn't possibly.
I
just looked
is,
at the list, though.
You might be right, but I saw,
yeah.
I thought I saw. But she was, because at first, I never really listened to Kesha music.
I yeah. actually fucking adore Kesha.
I used to.
I love her.
She was singing soft at first. I'm like, damn, because she even sing.
Yeah, yeah.
But
yeah.
She started singing powerful. I was like, damn.
And that song is actually, I mean, and of course, she, of course, it was a statement piece. But that song, I actually heard it like maybe like a month or two ago on my Pandora randomly. Mm-hmm. And I was just like, this is a powerful song. Like, that's a really good song. Like, the lyrics to that song.
Kesha makes me think of Janelle from Teen Mom.
Yes.
Because she was saying, she was risking her probation.
Her whole life. She was willing to go to jail because she couldn't miss the Kesha concert. She told her lawyer. She was like, no, she's a girl just like me. Like, we're just alike, and she's my idol. Her lawyer was like, you're going to go to jail.
I swear I thought that was...
He was talking about
Audra Day. That's what I said. I knew he was.
She resembles Rihanna, yes. But anyway, so
you want to talk to her?
I didn't even say I want to talk to Rihanna.
Right, I was like, how'd you talk with that? I'll talk to Audra Day.
Don't look at me like that, because if she hits you up, you're going to be happy.
What is wrong with you?
Like, my friends know you.
That's so insulting. Like, I don't know you, but my friends do.
I didn't ask for the feature. She did. So I'm like, my friends want me to do a song with you. So.
I don't know her either.
Look, I might not ask for it now.
She seems I like when Kesha's drunk and happy. And like, drunk
did you see
and like.
She asked for that.
I like
from Jerry Seinfeld.
Like
huh?
Jerry
Seinfeld. Oh, yeah.
Kesha?
What did he do?
She walked up to him. He was doing an interview. She it was like on a red carpet somewhere. She just walked up and tried to hug him. He was like,
oh!
And she's like, I just want to hug. He was like,
I don't know you.
Right. Oh. Yeah. I felt him like.
He literally was like, no.
But she has one of those faces that's like very, kind of like not basic, but just like, if you don't know her, you don't know her. Like,
even if I knew her.
She fits
like,
in.
Oh, like he was going to look at her and be like, oh,
like, if I knew her music like, was, but I didn't know her.
I thought she was about to say.
No, like, I didn't know she was average. Like, she fits in with the crowd. Like, you would be like, I don't know you.
I don't know.
Too many side
words. Worst moments.
And then I see you in public and you ask me for a hug. That's the first thing.
But you know my music?
It don't matter. Like, if I just know your art.
But you're a fan of it, right?
That's cool.
But you would, and you, like.
Hug?
Yeah. You're a fan of my music.
Not the
you
very were... first time I meet you.
Oh, that's true. I would hug the fuck out of Beyonce.
I'll walk up to you. I love your music. We'll walk the band. You know what I'm saying? Let's work sometime. If you up for it. Like, I introduce myself because you might not know who I am.
Because he would have hugged her if he knew her.
You would hug.
Okay.
That's weird.
I got to
stop playing. You know them like that.
Guys.
Worst moments. We got to do worst moments.
Wait, I have a couple more highlights.
No, Rihanna, we're not doing it.
Worst moments was all them damn. Go ahead.
Listen
to
me.
I wanted to talk about Janelle Monáe. And in the theme of just all of the, like I was saying earlier, about keeping up with this dialogue, she had a very good speech about the whole Time's Up movement. And I loved what she had to say. I loved what Logic had to say. I think that Logic is fantastic. I think that Logic is showing himself to be super unapologetic, which is appreciated, especially somebody who, and it's not the 1950s, so like, for a lot of people, passing might not be a thing, but he could really just slide through life and be like, I'm a little white boy, like, who cares? I just like rap music.
Passing is
still a thing.
I know, but I'm saying, like, I don't know how front of mind it is for some people, you know, until they come across it. But, like, Logic literally could be like, oh, just mind my business. Like, you know what I'm saying? Don't know what y'all talking about.
I thought he was white.
No, his father is black. His mother is white. He looks like a white person, though.
Logic gives me the vibes of, in, like, 30 years, if he doesn't have a career as a music artist, he will be on, like, BET late nights doing preacher things. That's the vibe.
That's why I felt you shady
earlier. I'm not being shady. I'm just saying.
I hope that's not shady. I love life.
What's wrong with being a preacher?
I mean, what's the wrong with being a preacher?
Quit preaching what they preaching is.
Oh. That's a line right there. Anyhow, worst moments. Worst moments.
All them damn country singers. Yeah, somebody don't like country music is cool. Country, I ain't gonna hate. But like they
moments.
Not running the world right now. Like ain't nobody listening to that shit for real.
There wasn't a worst moment. It was just an uninteresting moment.
Yeah, like a Little Big Town came out and they said Taylor Swift wrote that song, and I don't support none Taylor Swift do. So I just gotta walk away.
Wow. Let me think of moments that I was like, ooh, this is bad.
Oh. all the technical issues that I said earlier that I told y'all about.
You should write them letters and be like, I got a job. I need a job. I can help you.
Because they said on Twitter that Kendrick won Best Rap Performance before they announced it on TV.
On television.
And then...
Was that like the Grammy?
It's always...
That's it was like live, though. They
one
did
of
it
the hardest too. Things to do in the world as far as media, to send something live and like, you know, broadcast it live.
It was broadcast like out, like before the red carpet had ended. Like, oh, they said like Kendrick Lamar has won Best Rap Performance.
Like, congratulations.
Yeah.
And that was from
it was
the
like
Grammys
on Twitter. Film. Yeah, it was like Twitter. Yeah.
And
yeah,
like Ajinou Asia, I thought that meant that it wasn't going to
be
televised.
Yeah,
right. Because there's a lot of them that they don't televise.
But it was definitely still televised. So yeah. I was like, why did you tell us this?
Yeah.
It was like before I watched
and y'all had access to the Grammy account?
Hell yeah. Whatever the question
y'all
is.
Y'all wouldn't leak shit?
Oh, no, I wouldn't leak anything.
Why not? What if somebody offered you money to do it?
Depends on the money.
Would you lose your job?
No.
I mean, I don't fuck with the Grammy, so if
but
I
don't
work
there.
But
he
why
said
do you
if
work
I just
there?
Had access.
Why do you work there if you don't fuck with them?
But he said if you have access. Yeah. That don't mean I'll
that's
work
like 90% of America, though.
No.
Why
not
do you
like
work
with
there
the
if
Grammys,
you don't fuck
though.
With them?
That's a legit-ass, like, career type
yeah.
job. I'm not going there and I don't fuck with you.
Well, no, I'm like, but if I
take this job.
If I got an email, if I got an email right now with somebody that was like, this is a fucking zip drive to all of the fucking winners for next year's Grammys, and then 2 days later, somebody else was like... And here's $500,000 for you to just fucking tweet it.
And you're you.
Like, yeah, I don't work there. But I just
right.
No, that's what I meant
people,
when that's what I heard.
How many
people
think
that
access to the winners? Because
probably 20.
That sounds.
That's
that
a
deal.
That makes sense.
Yeah, that makes sense to me.
That makes sense.
I wanna. Never mind. See, I'm getting
too access to shit because 20 is too many.
Well, that's such a big thing, though, with some people working on it, that they probably
it's
have
probably,
to have more
yeah.
than one.
But you probably got the people who are on the board. Are they considered Academy, too? Are they considered Grammy Academy?
Yeah.
Sure.
I'm sure.
You probably got the people who are on the Grammy Academy, and then you probably get, like, whoever's in charge of, like, the Twitter or their marketing or whatever. So, it's probably not a lot.
You remember when that dude
that's
tweeted
what?
Nigger Navy?
What?
Oh, God. Anyway,
I
was my favorite thing.
I don't know
you didn't listen
that
to that's back before she was on that podcast. I went nuts. It was hilarious to me. But anyway, that's beside the point. Highlights. I think I got through it all. Oh, the fucking celebrities reading from the book Fire and Fury, which was fantastic.
Loved it.
I just love how like I think that it's a couple of things, right? It's like. Legitimately, like, let's take a stance and talk about what we believe and about how 45 is, whatever. But then also, I think that it was such shade intertwined into everything, because they know that how egotistical he is and how, like, he's watching this or at least sees it. And I don't know.
He's
I just,
gonna respond.
Like, it was like a legitimate, like, I just want to fucking ruin his night. And that's what I think they did. But I thought that it was really
Cardi,
funny.
I loved Cardi
I
in that
her.
Segment. Because Cardi is so real in everything she does. Like, her true personality shines in every, like, thing that I ever see her in. Like, she was genuinely like, really? Like, I feel like she thought that part that they showed wasn't going to be in it. I feel like she thought that, like, she was just, like,
when she said she could feel her nerves in her vagina?
No.
Oh.
When she was reading it and was like, it was like, what? Like, this is really how he lives his life? Like, this is crazy. Like, she was just like talking to the camera people.
Yeah.
And I think that, like, she probably didn't even think
she's
that was
so
going to
get
aired. Like,
yeah.
She was just talking. Like, that's crazy.
No, on the red carpet, they were asking her, like, oh, like, are you nervous? She was like, yeah, I can feel butterflies in my stomach and my vagina.
Yeah.
And I was just like, this girl is a national treasure. Yeah, for sure. On national television. It was great. Was that the worst moments? The technical difficulties? There had to be something that I saw that I was like, meh.
Migos didn't win shit.
Was they nominated for
it? Rap album. That's the one I thought they would win, just because they had so many songs. Hold on. Give me that shady look. They had so many songs that was popping off this year, like, yeah, Jay-Z, he had a couple songs, but I'm a big Jay-Z fan. I listened to that album. That's nowhere near my favorite. You
mm-hmm.
feel me? Kendrick had a really, really good album, really
mm-hmm.
solid album. And he had a lot of songs that was popping off, so I'm not mad that he won. Mm-hmm. But I thought Migos, like, they had a lot of shit popping off this year.
Mm-hmm.
And Bad and Bougie didn't win. Like, that was the one, another one I thought I knew would win. Like, that shit was popping off.
And
which one
won? Kendrick won that too, right?
Yeah.
The Humble?
Yeah. Was it Humble? No, that was...
Because that was like Song of the Year, right? Hip Hop Song of the Year or something? Or Hip Hop Record of the Year?
No.
I think that was
Humble. He won. Hella, she won like five. I know he won for the song with him and Rihanna. I know he won Hip Hop. He won everything rap.
But anything Bad and Bougie was up for, I would have expected. That would have made sense to win, though.
Yeah.
Bad and Bougie. Even Bodak Yellow.
You feel me?
Yeah.
But I ain't mad. Whatever.
I was very disappointed that SZA didn't win anything at all, because she was like the most nominated female artist. But also, you know, whatever.
I called you.
But I think that I hope that she doesn't seem like the type that, I mean, that could be a bruise to your ego, but she doesn't seem like the type that was like, they fucking snubbed me. Like how everybody on social media is, they're like, they fucking, you know, snubbed all these people, but including Jay-Z.
If you want to win,
suck a dick.
You want to win, Kanye West showed y'all the recipe if you want to win the Grammys.
Tell us more.
What you mean? Kanye West be snapping off at every award show he don't win and he feel like he should have won.
Oh,
and then what happened? Kanye is probably the most decorated rapper ever. He has hella Grammy awards.
Thoughts I never thought.
You got to go up in there and make them uncomfortable. And you got to make music that they can't deny.
Yeah.
You got to make it make sense.
You got to make music that puts you in the room, and then you got to make them uncomfortable enough to be like, damn, we can't not put them in the room. And if we put them in the room, we can't not let them win, because...
Yeah.
He's going to be mad.
It's going to be some dreadhead niggas in the lobby.
You feel me? But when niggas start sending the Grammys up, we going to be uninvited again.
Those were the days. Anyway, so I guess that's it for the Grammys. I can't think of anything else. Can you? I think we got a game to play, though.
Look at that game.
Oh, God.
Reach under your chairs.
Okay.
And see what good
it's a have. New car.
It's construction paper.
Oh, yeah. Oh, my favorite.
So,
don't look.
He has to know which colors I want.
Are you gonna switch?
He said he's picking his colors already.
Yeah, I already picked.
That's
okay.
Not how that works.
That's
not.
How,
no, just
say it. Ladies. So the game is yep or no.
No, it is not.
No,
never mind. It is yep or no.
Stop it. Anyways, so yep. It's basically either yes, you've done it, or yes, like, you like it, you agree with it. It's basically the positive.
You might
so right. For whatever the question is.
And nah is nah.
Hell
no. Nah is just...
No. Hell no.
Nah is
hell no. I didn't do it, or
I'm telling my no, baby. Hell no.
Okay, here we go. I'm excited. I love games.
Okay, so the first one is Curvy Rihanna.
Oh. Hell yeah.
Nice.
And fucking fuck off to everybody that keeps saying that she's fucking hiding her baby bump. She's...
Even if she was. So, I'm here for it.
Like, damn, like, why can't women just grow? Like, why can't we just get chubby? Because I'm rich as fuck and I'm living my best life.
And I'm in love.
And I got this billionaire fucking Arabian Indian dude, whoever he is, goddamn prince. He's one of the wealthiest men on earth.
And she been out
and she's getting banged up by him all the time.
That makes sense.
She was like, and, like 18 when she eating. Came out.
Nothing less for people.
She was like 16.
So. That's what I'm saying. Makes
sense.
Yeah. Tiny,
yeah, like what the fuck?
All right.
Sorry.
Kendrick Lamar's Grammy performance.
Oh, yeah. You didn't watch
you
it.
I'm going to just say.
By default, though.
You better not look at that camera. If I got
to put that by default, I'm going to say nah.
Because
I asked her what it was.
You didn't like it.
And
before?
I guessed what it was.
Here's before the she thing, guys. When I say nah, I don't literally mean I didn't like it. I just mean I just kind of want to have fun sometimes.
Oh and it's not the time
like,
to have fun.
It's not that. It's it not to be not like. Fun. I don't want to be like. I'm not like against the statement pieces and the like. It's not like I'm against it. But sometimes I do want to just. I just want to have fun, Kendrick. And so I did not like it. I just wanted to have fun. But instead I was like,
I feel it though. She's all right. Out of all the songs that he had popping off this year, he picked the song that, you know what I'm saying, he had
DNA.
A conscious-ass performance. He could have did Love.
That's what I wanted.
He could have did
But he also...
Them was the best songs on the album.
He did a... It was a combination of that and the song from the Black Panther movie. So yeah. I feel like that was also like a little message.
SZA,
you know?
Before I do it?
No, it wasn't that song. He got a song with like Future.
I know Future. For his ass.
No, somebody else.
Talking about hold on.
How Future wasn't nominated for nothing?
That's not the game. We gotta stay on target.
That
okay?
nigga snapped last year.
Kiss the girl.
Oh, happily kiss.
A girl? Yeah, when I was a boy.
On the lips.
When I was a boy.
Aw, cute.
I'm an adult man now. I can't be kissing girls.
You. That's very good.
No Harvey Weinstein.
That's very good. That's very
been
good.
Been in a music video.
Salt Shaker. I was, though.
DJ Khaled's Salsa Dancing.
Super hell no.
Say yes because I just feel like he's just living his best life. He's just doing whatever. Yes, the problem.
Had sex and didn't remember it.
How am I supposed to say no to that?
Yeah, well, today I don't remember.
If I didn't remember
girl,
it,
you could have said, you could have known you had sex, like woke up with the person, like, but you just don't remember it. Like you just laying there, like I really don't remember last night, but our clothes are off.
I feel like that's bound to have had happened before. I don't know.
Okay. SZA not winning any Grammys.
I'm mad.
She should have won Best Work.
Definitely.
Having sex with your hand.
Huh?
Sex?
What's that, masturbation?
Sex with your hand.
Sure.
Or like...
masturbation.
Fingering.
That's...
Either way.
Either way, same.
I'm saying though, like
I actually don't like to finger girls.
Dropped out of college.
Oh, all the time.
I did it twice.
All the time. It's our favorite pastime. Yeah. It's our favorite pastime.
It's our
favorite. Okay. Last one. Had a one night stand.
But that green up, you want to throw green up so bad, man.
Just because you told me to.
Always fucking twice, you Dot Markee. Always fucking twice.
Only because Alja told me to. She just told me to.
That was fun. Thanks, guys.
That
I thought
as
you
bad
were going
to.
I thought you were going to do sex with feet.
Sex with feet. So we can all say no and Brie can say yes. That's all she wanted to
wait,
do.
You got sex with the foot or you did sex
no.
with the foot?
She gives people sexual foot right. with her feet.
It's a gift.
You give people sexual foot with your feet.
What
I said
do you
sexual
stand on?
Pleasure.
You sit on your wet foot?
I said she gives sexual pleasure.
Or you sit on your hands.
What?
I'm asking
what
how
you
she feels.
He
said he want to try new stuff.
Why would I sit
that's
on my hands?
Now
you're
going too far. My girl going ahead is and sweet.
She can be the one.
No, I'm saying she can learn how to do it. It's
you,
a gift.
You
I
sit down on your butt and
you know,
do it
like,
with your feet.
I have a thing where like, my feet
yeah.
cramp a lot if they turn a certain way. So I imagine
you
like
said your
just
feet
getting
hurt?
Kind of foot cramps.
Oh.
Like if I bend my foot a certain way,
no, that
it
makes
cramps
sense.
Up immediately. So I just imagine like
yeah.
getting really bad foot cramps.
You just got, I mean.
You just have to oil your feet up real good.
That
stick,
no,
stick in between the big toe and the middle
no,
toe.
No, hell no. What
girl, I'm doing it with the paw, the leg of the
no, you
right
use
now.
Both of your feet.
You know who else gives game. Like foot pleasure? Carly Red from Love & Hip Hop Atlanta.
Good for her.
So she thinks Young Jock
like
that. No, she doesn't.
Oh.
I remember they said it like a woman.
I haven't done that in a long time, but I just don't believe in leaving your partner unsatisfied. So if I'm on my period and I don't feel like sucking dick, I got hands and I got feet. You make a choice.
Why can't you use your breasts?
Hands, though, like...
Or
yeah, titties. But, no, back then I didn't have titties. These are new.
Put it into the armor.
Yeah, in here.
Where are y'all taking it?
Like,
y'all got it? Y'all got it in your arms to go somewhere? You girls are
just
weird.
Wearing
that's,
it?
That's super awkward. Like, somebody was like, yeah, I got you with these feet.
I definitely it works. It works.
You would probably let a girl do it if she
yeah.
wanted to try.
I definitely would.
Gina Markee girlfriend.
Gina Markee girlfriend.
Say
that can't be her whole title.
That's just a generalization.
Gina Markee
girl. No, it's not with your toes. It's with the arches of your feet.
Fuck you.
Just hella cramps.
My girl, no, like that's I'm. I'm down to try some shit, but foot, nah. What you, no.
Do you not like feet?
I don't mind feet. I rub her feet all the time. What, nigga?
He was gonna be sure.
Anyway, this is as good a time as any to go ahead and wrap up. We definitely want to thank Dot Markee for coming and kicking it with us and talking trash with us. Make sure that you and go and get the album today, right? Right now. Like, yeah, right now.
It's out.
Mm-hmm. Right now. Where can we find it?
www.g.markee.com. That's GDOTMARKEE.
Yes.
All the videos on the website.
All he's selling the cards, the too?
Cards come with the album.
Oh,
you buy cards.
Come on. So, package deal?
Oh, that's expensive. You know, we ain't taking no shorts on that.
Okay.
But, you know, so, if y'all want to go ahead.
These not limited, right?
Yeah, this limited. It's only 100 made, and we sold about half of them already. So, they come with a nice certificate that proves the authenticity. Because
you got everything.
I'm just saying, like, somebody could just go make that shit.
Yeah.
But if they ain't got my autograph on the certificate.
It's not real.
Because these going to be worth some money one day.
I'm going to tell them at the swamp, the Boulay.
That's the swamp. Tell them where they can follow you on social media,
_ G.Markee, GDOTMARKEE on IG and Twitter. You can find me at G.Markee on Facebook if you use that.
Perfect.
I kind of be getting it popping on Facebook.
Yeah, I do be seeing you.
Yeah, I got a snap, but
you don't snap much.
You know, like, when Instagram Live came out, and people, like, they start putting stories on Facebook and Snap, because I don't even really put a story on Snap, so when they start putting on IG and Twitter, and Facebook, I was just like, I realized how insignificant it was. Wow. I don't really like Snap. Snap is for, like, people.
I think it's for like cheating and just bad behavior. Like,
definitely.
If you're just trying to like just mess with people and you're not supposed to be messing with
Snap.
People, like you just want it to disappear
Snap
when you're
just
done.
For cheaters and drug dealers.
Like so you can.
Yes.
My friend always talks about how he has tons of girls that only send him like nudes and pics and things like that via Snapchat.
Where
like,
I send my nudes
they know it'll disappear.
Because I want you to keep that shit.
No, but here's the thing. Like,
but she's not sending it to nobody that you're not supposed to.
That's true.
So
I'm not sending it to nobody that I'm not supposed to, but I'm not getting nudes.
Getting
at this stage in your life.
Yes.
Period.
You've got wiped
up G.Markee. Knows nothing about it.
Period.
Okay. So anyway.
He said, period.
Like I was saying, please continue to do
send
all things. Yes. Send you that
because he doesn't know
no,
about.
Guys.
No,
send us a committed relationship.
He's a,
yeah, send to all of us some
send
money.
A dollar with all your news.
Send me some count.
If it's just titties, 50 cents, it's fine. anyway, please continue to do all the things that you've always done and follow us on all the places to be. You can follow us at Away With Words the Podcast on Instagram, Tumblr, Twit Twat, and Facebook, and right here on the YouTube. So make sure that you. What are you doing?
I forgot I brought y'all gifts. Y'all like
gifts?
Yeah, I got chocolate and I got.
He's got a bag
sour.
Of good. Seriously, this sounds like I'm gonna take a bite and pass out. He's gonna drag me.
I got 3 chocolates and I got 2 sours, so.
I want a sour.
Y'all can decide.
Because it's limited.
Y'all can figure out what chocolate.
I
want
to know
sour.
What kind of chocolate is it.
Can we get off camera first?
No.
I don't
want to
put it on the camera.
Alright,
we'll get off camera and we'll do it.
Jesus Christ.
You don't want to put another, he's a nice guy. It's the only time
he's
we've ever had
gifts in our life. And she don't want it to be televised.
I thought that was customary. You
ever
bring
given
gifts
us
when you go somewhere.
You're the only one that cares. You don't understand. You're the only one that cares. Nobody's ever brought us shit.
She's very upset about it.
Well, I'm setting the standard. Don't let no niggas exactly. Come up here and ain't brought you shit.
And don't let anybody fuck you that won't eat you out first.
Yes.
That's what you were saying, right?
That's not what I was saying.
And don't let anybody eat you out that won't let you foot fuck them.
Anyway, guys, I'm not
don't
saying
go by that shit.
I'm not saying all of that again.
Break laws, avoid jail. How about that?
Okay, and subscribe, like, comment, share. Fuck with the people
disgusting.
Who fuck with you, and we fuck
keep
with you.
Disgusting.
And make sure that you follow me at Bri.Stories on Instagram, at Bri_Stories on Twitter, at Atati on.
Anything, just say anything.
Twitter.
IG.
Or A Tati on fucking Instagram. Damn. And that Hey Tati.
Know. She just don't know.
No, this is like check in for me. I really cannot ever remember. And Hey Tati on the fucking other thing.
Hey Tati on Twitter, but the what? H Hey Tati was gone. I couldn't put it on Instagram. So I had to get creative.
Ajanoasia. At Ajanoasia everywhere. Yes, everywhere. Thank you so much. Everybody say bye.
Bye. Bye.